Hi, it's Larry here of Xbox Live's Major Nelson. Welcome to the show. We're back with you, and joining me in, let me bring him in through the power of the technology.
the whoosh that I felt like coursing through that, the internet tubes.
Well, because it's a little warm here in Seattle, that was a rush of cool air that I blew your way.
Could use that. The land that air conditioning forgot. I didn't forget it.
I didn't. I missed it. We didn't forget it up here. Welcome to the show. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here. We did a show last week. It was a bit busy.
Yeah, we're doing things a little different this week. Normally we post on Fridays. We're posting this on Monday because, well, we needed the weekend. And two.
So relaxed.
Are you? And number two, we have this great interview coming up to talk about what was released earlier, a blog post that went up earlier today about the brand new Xbox store experience coming to preview members. And I'll have an interview with Cody Bird, who's a PM on that team. You and I have been using the store for quite some time, and we love it.
Speaking of a rush, this thing moves fast. Like it blows your hair back. It's very snappy. Snappy is the way I would call it. I'm going to keep the theme going, Larry. I can't wait till you all see it. And I'm looking forward to hearing from Cody.
By the way, I have a new, there are people looking at you and I feel like I have a new lower third for you, if I may.
That's me. That's how I identify.
Touched up the animation and brought it in. So trying to
I like that. That's
trying to move this show a little forward. So
you get to put on your resume Chiron operator.
Yeah, exactly. That
as someone who's done that, it's a challenging and fun job. So I enjoy the creativity.
It is, especially live.
You still haven't fixed the space though. It looks like Larry Hryb at Major Nelson.
Yeah, That's my next thing to fix. So I'm going to go ahead and take care of that and fix that next. So there we go. In the meantime,
the animations, Dan. This is like the ultimate PowerPoint deck. I love it.
Well, you know, when you do, it's as you and I have a tremendous history in television, you know, and now we're sitting at home with our own television studios. Why not? The only thing, and I think I mentioned this in one of our very early shows, the biggest disappointment I have in this software, it's called vMix. It's great software. It doesn't have a star wipe.
We need to get you a Grass Valley switcher with like the handle that pulls
back. I do have
back.
The handle. There's a virtual handle wipe on the screen here.
It's not the same.
I can go like this and go right back and see and go back
you
and forth.
The manual pull. See, it's almost like it feels like this. Look at this. You're right. You're fired. But it's like the Star Wars, like you're launching into hyperspace in the Millennium Falcon.
Well,
that's what that switcher feels like. And
actually,
you want that.
You say that, and here's a funny little tidbit. If you look at Star Wars: A New Hope, there is a.
I've looked at it several times.
I don't know if it's a Grass Valley switcher, but when they're about to blow up Alderaan, there's a close up of all the buttons, and they push the T bar forward, and that is a TV switcher. I'll have to go find that because it's what it is.
I mean, Grass Valley was the height of 80s technology. I guess that was the 70s. I'm going to look at that. I'm going to see what it was. See if I can identify it.
Anyway, here we are. We're back. We're going to talk about what we're playing. We're going to talk about a bunch of different things. And then later on, we're going to do a demo of the brand new Xbox store. Cody's going to sit down and I'm going to drive and we're going to go through it. And we're really excited about that. It's going to Xbox Insider like soon, like in a couple days. It may be there already, depending upon when you're listening to this, but we'll talk about that. So let's jump right in.
Don't get pulled over in your test drive. That thing. It goes faster than the speed limit.
It is fun. So here we are. So hey, you want to talk about what you're playing? Because it looks like you've got. Do you have Grounded up in the background there?
I do. Damn, wrong hand. Over there. Yeah. So that's Grounded. Grounded came out this week from our good friends at Obsidian down in Orange County, California. And this is a game that's in game preview, an Xbox game preview. That means this is really just a taste of what the final version of the game is going to have to offer. But I will say that taste is pretty damn tasty. I mean, there's a lot here to play with, and the mechanics are super solid. Yep. I've played all manner of like
in-progress games. And it's preview right now. It's not even final release.
Exactly. And that's what's so impressive is it feels really polished. You're going to find some glitches here and there. The story, as it were, ends like just as you're getting going because they will add more over time.
I believe we call that a cliffhanger in the business.
Yes. But in terms of like the core mechanics and the world building, this feels really good. And like the intersection of the different insects, and they're going, they're doing their own thing. And like, you can get in there and you can mix it up, but sometimes it's best to just let nature be nature. I think that we could all learn a lesson from that. Let's let nature just do its
own
thing.
And I know there's, what's interesting is, and I guess you, Jeff, you and I can talk about this now, because we've been on the inside and watching the development of the game from a little bit of afar. But one, and I host, this is actually one of the very last public events I did before everybody went into COVID shutdown at PAX East. This year. I hosted a panel with some of the folks, and we were talking about it. And one of the big areas of concern was people that are afraid of spiders, right?
Absolutely. And I will say, I live with my daughter. She's a huge fear of spiders, like to the point where if there's a spider outside, I'm instructed to go kill it. And then I don't really kill it. Spiders are supposed to be outside in the house.
You rehome it?
All rules are off. This is my, I just move it away from the door. We have a spider stick. There's a lot of spiders in Seattle.
Is that something you buy on Amazon?
Bamboo stick. It's just like a little bamboo stick, and I'll clean out the cobwebs, and the spider will usually land on it, and I'll just sort of drag it into the hedge or something like that.
I see.
I don't want them laying eggs right near the door, and then one day you open the door when the eggs are hatching. I don't know if you've ever seen that. It's raining spiders.
I've told you that story, right?
I love how we're talking about arachnophobia mode. Let's talk about spiders. Let's talk about our grossest spider. I would actually love to hear it.
I think I told the story, but when my wife and I were first dating, actually, I think we've just gotten married. We're in Connecticut, and we had our first place together, and she went out and got a Christmas tree, a brand new, cut it down, went to the tree farm, cut it down, put it in the house, and I was at work, and she was decorating it. And she was underneath trying to get it into the base, the Christmas tree base.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
And she's under there. And as she's under there, like tightening it up and kind of straightening it out and putting the lights up, she felt the water coming down all over her face. And then she couldn't figure out what it was. And she goes like this, because she brought it from the outside in, there were spiders that started to hatch when they hit the warm room. And there were hundreds of baby spiders coming down over her face.
That is nightmare material.
And
oh my God.
To this day, we do not have a live tree anymore. We have an artificial tree because of that reason. She's like, nope, we're done.
So she's someone who should take advantage of arachnophobia mode. So what this is it's actually at the very beginning when you launch the game, it goes right into accessibility. You can do it from the get. And you can essentially slide. Do you want it to look like a spider? And it does look frightening. They're huge. They're much bigger than you are. Do not pick a fight with them unless you are well equipped. At the very beginning of the game, you are not well equipped. You're not going to kill it with a rock.
Let's be clear. You're about this big. Jeff, your spider stick in this case would not work. No spider stick here.
My spider stick would be the size of a skyscraper in this world. So you can slide it, and with each notch along the pathway on the slider, it looks less and less like a spider. At the end, it's basically like two cute little orbs. Right. Here's the thing, though. It's still just as deadly in the game. It just doesn't look like a spider. So my daughter, who slid that thing all the way to the right, she was like, oh, what's that little thing? And then it killed her. So we actually had to like dial it back and make it a little bit more spider.
So she could tell what it was.
Spiders look that way for a reason, to scare the hell out of you, so you stay away. Like, we have an innate fear of spiders more than I think, like, it's in our DNA. And I think she had chibied it. She had made it look so cute that she lost her fear of it. And that's where things go wrong.
Always respect the spider.
Yes, exactly.
Now,
it's a really fun game.
Yeah, check it out. If you're an Xbox Game Pass member, you can check it out right now. It's in game preview, but you can check it out right now and kind of go through. And the tip that Jeff gave me, because I was having a problem with this, can we give a little bit of the tip? Why don't you give the tip that you gave me about the water?
What was it?
The water.
I don't remember. Oh, yeah. Yeah, exactly. So you are monitoring your hunger and your thirst. And if you run for too long, you will get really thirsty, as tends to happen. Yep. And we're trying to figure out, like, how do you drink? Now, there's puddles on the ground, and they'll even say, like, do I want to drink this? And if you're desperate, sure. But it will end up hurting you, and you will lose hunger.
Right, right.
But if you look up into the grass that is sort of it's sort of like is bent over, you will see way above your head, you'll see like a drop of water there. If you whack that with your axe,
yeah.
do. It's called Dew, but it's huge in this game.
Right.
You'll hit it. You hit it one time. You'll hear the drop, and then it'll slide down the hill or whatever. So you have to chase that water. Drinking the Dew water is clean and is the best way to sate your thirst.
Later this on, game brought to you by Mountain something. Dew.
Exactly. It's inevitable. Eventually, you... Right. No, I guess we should be serious. It's probably not. You can build a device that actually attracts Dew, so you don't have to wander around looking like this. Next thing you know, you've wandered into a spider's
den. Is it like a divining stick, like old school?
I think it's some manner of thing. Well, no, it attracts the Dew, so the Dew forms there repeatedly.
I see.
As opposed to having to go out and look for it. It's a lattice. How about that?
Okay. All right.
Lattice. Good word. So even after you finish the objectives in the game, and it takes you down into a place and you meet a character, and that's when it ends, like just as it's heating up, you could still continue to play. You can build up your base. There's base building mechanics. And I really like how they do it. So you sort of, when you go into build modes, you say, I want to have a wall here. I want to have a wall here. I want to put a door here. And it sort of like ghosts out. You see it, but it's not really there until you bring those equipment. So when you bring, you like cut down blades of grass.
So you're pre-vising, as we say in movie making. You're pre-visualizing how you want it to be.
Exactly. It's like AutoCAD, you know, like assisted design.
Another classic callback.
And then you plug in the ingredients when you have them, and it becomes real, corporeal, if you will. So I really like that, because you don't have to like have all the equipment to start building. You can get started and sort of you plan out your dream home. It's almost like putting it on Pinterest or something, and then you go out there.
It's your minute vision board.
Exactly. Yeah. And there's some really cool abilities. There's also, you can build armor, and it really stacks up. You bring certain things in as you find them, and you can get them analyzed in this area, and then you learn recipes that way. Well, and there's a lot of depth there. So for stage one of Xbox game preview, for Grounded to have this much is like really exciting, because I think it's just going to continue to develop, and we'll let you know as new enhancements come in, as they add new content, and it's going to be one to keep watching. I think this one's going to have a nice life to it.
Completely agree. In fact I posted on Twitter how I succumbed to the spiders.
Don't mess with the spiders till you're ready. Saw one or two and I just ran in the other direction. I did not hesitate.
So I think it's, you know, you talked about the look of the spiders. I think it's also the sound of them, right?
Everything about them. It's just on a cellular level, you are just like repulsed.
Right.
And it actually doesn't bother me that much, but they are a frightening beast of nature. And for them to be like the big bads, at least that we've seen thus far.
Let's be clear, you're this big.
Yeah. Yeah. So, you know, whatnot of that. Another interesting thing that you'll start to see this week, actually, is we worked with a number of, look, you get made really tiny. So we worked with a lot of content creators, influencers, you might call them.
Tiny ones?
Cool and crazy PCs. Well, we challenged them to build the smallest PC that they could build that would run Grounded.
Sure.
And so you're going to see those coming up. It's a challenge. I believe you'll be able to vote. We gave them a certain amount of money that they could do it. And so if you look over on Xbox Wire, you can see who those folks are. Keep an eye. I worked with there's people from all over the globe. So we worked specifically with Austin Evans. He's the U.S. representative. He's a very talented guy. You might know him as
the viewer might remember
he was somebody that actually, probably the only person you've seen that has held an Xbox Series X in their hands.
When we had him on campus earlier this year. Yeah,
exactly. And so we challenged him, and I will say he really knocked it out of the park. It's really cool what him and his team were able to build. You have to see it. It's very intelligent.
Now, I'm going to tell you right creative. Now, if I haven't seen these yet, but if any of these creators do not build Uncle Milty's ant farm into this PC, I am going to be tremendously disappointed.
What is that?
I want you to look it up right now. Look up Uncle Milty's Ant Farm. It was on the back when I was growing up. It was the back of comic books. And it was this clear. Do you see it?
Ants. Yeah. Well, it's auto-filling.
So
on Bing as I look. Okay, so it's like an ant farm. It just happens to be, it's called the Uncle Milton.
Uncle Milton, Uncle Milton's ant farm, right. And it was like this two planes of gas.
I wanted one as a kid.
And you can see them, you can see where they dig and stuff. It was kind of cool but you know, it feels like they should be, that's what we should do.
You could still buy them. In fact, UncleMilton.com is still a thing. I always wanted one as a kid.
Is it optimized for Netscape?
My mom would not let me bring bugs. No, it's they apparently have a deal with Marvel. So Uncle Milton's going strong. Look, as long as there are ants, there will be Uncle Milton's ant farm, apparently.
I'm telling you.
In fact, it's the 60th anniversary ant farm. Did you have the no. V1?
No.
Used. It was handed down to amused, you.
But no.
Larry, take the bait.
Not that old.
It actually won a National Parent Product Awards. This looks really cool. The problem is again,
you learned something today, Jeffrey, and I feel good. I feel good that I have introduced you to Uncle Milton.
Yeah, well, I had heard of an ant farm. I'd seen an ant farm. I just didn't know about
urban legend.
How did they get the ants to you? Or do you just pick them up?
You know that I don't know. This is like, I don't know if the same thing as sea monkeys. You just add water.
Yeah, I don't know, because it's like if you do this in Florida, you pick up a fire ant. You don't want none of that. I still have a scar.
You don't.
Somewhere on my hand from 1992. Right.
Yeah, my mother when she lived down there.
It was on this finger.
They're
not good.
Not good.
No.
Anyway.
No.
Ants.
Ants, the real spiders. God, if they put fire ants in that game. No, thank you. Hey, you know what eats bugs?
What eats bugs?
Toads. Toads, Larry. Yes, and guess what? We had a great announcement. What a segue. Battletoads is incoming. Comes out August 20th. That's like not even 3 weeks away from now. So Battletoads... this looks like a Saturday morning cartoon come to life. And so very much looking forward to it. You might have played way, way back in the day, the original Rare Battletoads on like NES. V1. It was known for being just so difficult. One of the most challenging, difficult games of all time. Yeah. It was like a quarter muncher arcade game, but placed on a home console. And anyway, this is like, it's amazing how far it's come. So it's coming August 20th. It's going to be part of Xbox Game Pass. I think you're going to see people like us struggling. You're going to see people speedrunning it, beating the game quickly.
I think you can pre-download it now if you're a Game Pass member, right?
Well, I'll have to take a look. I know it is coming to Game Pass on both Xbox One and PC. It's coming to Steam as well. Yep. So very excited about that. Pre-installation on PC will be available soon. So by the time you hear this, it's possible. So go jump onto your console or jump onto the Xbox app on your PC and go ahead and click and see if it downloads. This will be a fun one to play. We should play it in co-op, Larry. You have to play it in co-op.
I'm with you. I'm totally down to do that.
Do you want to be Rash, Zitz, or Pimple?
I think Rash.
Rash is the one with the sunglasses, I think. Everyone wants to be Rash. I'll be... Zitz or Pimple. We'll figure it out.
What's left,
we'll
go right?
Zitz. Zitz is plural. But the animation style looks really cool. I love beat-em-ups. Had a great amount of fun with Streets of Rage 4 earlier this year. So this will be really fun. And apparently it's going to be funny. It's going to like really call back to like 90s humor.
Comedy, comedy.
Are there good neon colors in it?
Because that's 90s.
It is very bright. It is very colorful. And, you know, it's going to be a different type of game. I'm looking forward to it.
All right. You want to know what I'm playing? Can we talk about, a little bit about...
I would love to know what you're playing.
I am playing...
You said you were playing something fun.
I am playing Swim Out, which is, you can see behind me, you can see it's kind of my most recent guy. I've got Apex Legends here. I Destroy All Humans, Grounded. But Swim Out is one that, I think it's in Game Pass too, but this is a fun puzzle game where you have to basically swim around through this pool. You're the blue capped swimmer.
Oh, okay. It's a top down view. I can see that.
Yeah. So you kind of have to go through here and get to, and I'm like six or seven levels in, but I love the artistic style of this. I'm a huge fan of swimming pools. I don't have one yet, but I love the whole pool vibe. So this game is, and it's got puzzles. So this game is right up my alley. So I'm really excited.
Yeah. The font that you had there on your desktop, I could kind of see there, or on the dashboard, it has that sort of Art Deco Bioshock kind of look to it.
Well, it feels like you and I, you know, we should be in Miami out on what's that road?
The Fountain Blue?
A1A
Beachfront Avenue?
Yeah. Beachfront Avenue. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't think We'll do it. I don't know if the beaches are open right now. I think they closed the beaches. But
anyway, so swim out. You can't get to the.
Here's the secret. You don't go there in the summer. It's too hot. You know, it's 94 degrees outside with 100% humidity. Last thing you want to do is be under the sun. Any like sun damage I have to my face is from doing that when I was in high school.
Well, that explains why you are enjoying the Northwest.
I have had more than enough vitamin D to last several lifetimes. I want to be as pale and pasty as possible now. Well, sitting by the window is an outdoor
activity. So far, so good.
I know. Look at this. The light. I would say it's the lighting, but I'm at risk of blending in with the wall behind me, which isn't great.
I am. I've had a heck of a week. I was last week. I was on a bunch of different podcasts. I was on. You want all those?
It was essentially Major Nelson week on Kind of Funny, which was really cool to see.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun to talk to Greg and the gang and the X-Cast gang. So if you go check those out at Kind of Funny, I had a real good conversation with them. I really enjoy those guys.
That's awesome. Yeah. A big fan. I've known Greg for a long time. I think it is a little humbling when Greg asked me if you would like to be on We Have Cool Friends. And I'm like, yeah, you would. I think you'd love it.
I believe you did come up a couple times during the show, so I don't remember exactly what that
was. All right, I'll take it. Did he mention Zombie Blog Knack?
Yes,
he
did.
My wife making the minis. Yes, exactly. I've been a recurring joke since that was Podcast Beyond, over 10 years ago. And occasionally, I will still reply to something and someone goes, Zombie Blog Knack! Is your wife still making the minis? And she's moved on. She moved on. We should all move on.
Speaking of moving on, you know what we should do now is we've been going for about 20 minutes. We should stop right now and we should bring in Cody Bird in the interview that I did a couple of days ago. This, what you're going to see now is an interview with Cody. He is one of the project program managers for the new Xbox store that's coming to Xbox and Xbox One and Xbox Series X. And it's FAST. It's fast. It's flexible. It's secure and fun. Well, not secure, but it's fun. Well, secure if you there's some new kids stuff in there that we're going to talk about. So why don't we stop right now, take a look at that, and then we'll come back on the other side. How's that sound, Jeff?
Let's see that beautiful store.
A brand new Microsoft store experience is coming to Xbox Insiders, and joining me today is Cody Bird from the store team. Cody, good to see you, my friend. How are you?
Larry, thanks for having me. Yeah, I'm so glad to finally get a chance to share this with our faithful Xbox fans. This is a big day for us.
Well, it is my pleasure. I have to tell you, you know, you and I have worked together for quite some time, and one thing, you know, been working on the store team, and you guys have always come to you and say, hey, what can we do to make the store better? And well, you guys have been working on that for quite some time. And as I said just a moment ago, and there's a blog post that's up, I'll put a link in the comments and today, depending on when you're listening to it, but we've announced that there's a new store coming to Xbox Insiders. Just tell me a little bit about that. And then we're going to do a demo, Cody. We're going to do a demo.
Yeah, you bet. We're going to spend most of our time, I think, showing it off, which is exciting. It's been a long work in progress. I think the store is a place where we know our Xbox fans spend a lot of time discovering their new content, finding their next best thing to play, finding their next new Game Pass game to play. And we wanted to take this opportunity as we start getting into the Xbox Series X launch to do a real overhaul and rethink how we can make that experience the best it possibly can be. We've got a really big update that we hope everyone's going to be excited about and excited to share.
Now, this is, as we said, I'm going to say it multiple times because people think they're going to get this right away. This is on Insiders right now. And then the plan is you're going to roll this out over the coming months and then eventually wide release later this year. Is that right?
Yeah, that's totally right. So we're going to start with Insiders and get hands on with the millions of folks that we have in those rings today, get feedback, make sure that the changes we make are really resonating. And from there, we're going to start rolling that out to the general public. And we hope to have this in everybody's hands this fall.
Well, nobody wants to see you and I. They want to see the new store. So I'm going to cut right over this.
Such low res.
Well, we can hear you now. So here we are. This is my dashboard. This is a live demo. So anything can happen. And I'm going to go right into the store. And the first thing you're going to notice is the speed. Cody, you guys really worked on the speed here. So let's go through that. And then we can kind of go through the demo a little bit.
Yeah, you bet. I think the thing we're proudest of with the new Microsoft Store on Xbox is just how fast it's been. So we did a complete re-architecture of the app in the React Native on Windows. So as opposed to the previous framework, which while really versatile, had a lot of performance limitations, this new re-architecture allows us to launch the store in under 2 seconds, in some cases under 1 second. You can easily move between content, view things quickly. And as Larry said, you can pop in and out. That cold start was under 2 seconds.
Yeah.
If it's already in memory, it's almost instant.
Yeah. And so I want to talk about this because it's a complete redesign. You took a lot of what you learned from the, for lack of a better term, the original Xbox store. And this is, this is the third version. Did we talk? Because we talked about this. We had the one in the Xbox 360. We have Xbox One, and now we have this version, right?
That is correct. Yeah. So this is kind of you're right. And I hadn't really thought about it. We kind of have a every generation look at this. And this is a big change for us where a lot of what we're looking at is what we've learned from the work with Guide and how customers are really enjoying being able to navigate through their content in a more natural way through the channels and content blocks. And you kind of see as you scroll down, it really naturally flows to your different pieces of content. And we thought that bringing all of this up was going to make it easier for fans to find what's new, find what's happening in the store, and also just get to the things they care about. Do they want to search? Do they want to look for deals? Do they want to look at the newest games? Doing more to bring that all up to the top and getting that into a single store entry point was important to us.
And I see, here we go. We've got Game Pass Ultimate. All the games are in here. You can see the details about that offer. But the thing that's great is, I mean, where do you want to start? Because there's so much to cover here because it's so new. So I'm going to take your cue. Tell me where to go here, Cody.
Let's go ahead and let's just actually jump into games at the very top level. Let's check that out.
Okay. So you just click here and there you go. This is games. And again, this is a cold start. I loaded this. I haven't loaded this before. So this is right off the bat. So what do we got?
Exactly. Yeah. So what you'll find here is a couple of things. One, if folks were familiar with speaking of the Xbox One with the twists where we kind of had part of the store in an app and part of the store in the OS, we've consolidated everything together. So now when you're looking at this top of home and you're looking at your games, we'll make it really easy for you to find your deals, your subscriptions, things that are relevant to you based off your recent activity. Looks like maybe you've been playing some Apex Legends lately, Larry.
That is true.
we're kind of keeping an eye, trying to make it easier for people to find things. But one of the things we're most proud of actually, and this is a great showcase, is we're bringing more details about the games up to the top. So instead of having to load into a PDP, if you kind of pop in a game here, we start showing the trailer in line. We start giving more information about the game. We show more information about the sales and the deals. So if there's a sale going on, not just what percentage off and your price, but when does that sale end? Some more to make it, we use the word snackable a lot. We want to make it a lot easier to look and browse through the content and enjoy it. Like actually really enjoy going through and seeing the thousands of great games that are on the Xbox store.
This is a great example. So we'll take this game right here. We see a little bit of it. You can see, as you said, it's a new release. It's for family and kids. It's a sim strategy and the price. We can click in on this and instantly this feels new. So why don't you explain to us? I guess this is like a game detail page. Tell us what this is all about.
Yeah, exactly. So, one of the things is while we wanted to make it easier to browse through and kind of snack on content in those other browse experience, it was really important to us as well that when you dug in and really wanted to get into the details of a game, that was really thoughtful as well. So that same design we have where you kind of scroll down and these new chunks of content translates into the game details pages. You can easily view the trailers, view the screenshots, view the details of the game, like description, who developed it, what are the features and capabilities. If you want to know if a game uses Xbox Live and how, you can check that out in the details section.
One of the things I want to point out
is great display.
Yeah, and one of the things I want to point out is here, I'm going to go into, let's see, one of the enhanced games, we'll go into Forza, for example, we can see right there, it's included in Game Pass, how much it is. Now, we've also got additions, so this is something that a lot of people, here we go, here's the new additions, tell us about this.
Yeah, so this is a thing that we started exploring a little bit last holiday and had some really great success with our fans, had a lot of great success even with our publishers, really loving the display of this content. So once something we're doing with the new Microsoft Store and Xbox is we're doing more to surface the different editions of the game and make it easier for customers to choose and pick which one that they might want to play. So when you're in a game, when you go to view to a PDP, A, making those additions really clear. In some cases, even popping that up if we're thinking that, hey, maybe you didn't know which edition you meant to pick yet. We maybe start you here and help you pick which one. So that way, you know, a complaint we hear sometimes, and a fair one, is, man, with these games have so many different editions and so many different add-ons, how do I keep it all straight? And we're hoping that the new design helps clarify some of those details.
Yeah, I mean, you can kind of see right off the bat, here's what it includes. You can go left and right what the price is. If it's with Game Pass, of course, they're all with Game Pass. Yeah. The other thing that I noticed is that the new store, it's way easier to navigate with the controller. Yeah. Let's talk about some of the work you guys did there.
Yeah, and I think that's a great thing to call out. And, you know, without going too inside baseball, one of the things that was true about the Microsoft Store that's live now is it's a pretty shared code base between what we do on Microsoft.com store, what we do on our Microsoft Store on web. And while that had a lot of great efficiencies and opportunities to kind of keep a consistent experience, it didn't do as much as it could to celebrate the navigation and the power of the Xbox. So this new design we took on was really put first in mind with the notion of, I'm sitting, you know, 10 feet away from my 4K TV with a controller in my hands. How do I most easily navigate that through? And we have an excellent design team in Xbox who kind of went back to first principles and thought about how best can we navigate through all this new content, especially in a world where we have things like Game Pass that didn't exist when we launched the previous Xbox store, and all these new pieces of information we want to share about our games. It was a great chance to restructure. And part of that is this left navigation you see here, Larry, where, you know, when you're so many different ways to slice our catalog, not just our games, but our movies and our TV and our apps, helping people jump to the thing they care about and not having to navigate between menus is important. And this is another great addition that we're making, is kind of this gallery view. When you're viewing something that you want to really double click into, I want to view the top games, I want to view the Game Pass games. We show this richer gallery view where, just like before, if you sit on one of these games, you'll see the trailer, you'll see the details about, you know, what is its description, you know, the beginning of that description. And again, if you click into this, we're going to take you to that rich game details page where we're going to show you the full set of information you might want to know.
And there's the additions again. So we talked about it, you know, there's so much to talk about here, but kind of the themes we're seeing is it's faster. The new store is faster. You talked about being easier. We've redesigned a lot of things to work with the controller really, really well with the controller. And a lot of it's based on the feedback. So it's there's a lot of work going on there. You also did a little bit of work around the shopping cart. Let's talk about that. And the wish list. So let's go back up to the top here and show me. Let's talk through that.
Yeah. So one of the things that we added in the middle of the lifecycle of the previous store is like wish list in our shopping cart. And while those were great features, they were a little buried at times and hard to discover. So one of the things that we're really putting a lot of energy into is when you go to any game details page experience, making it really easy to add that game to your wish list here. You can see kind of in that third button, add it to your shopping cart. And when you have those things inside of your wish list, if you go back to that, or your shopping cart, if you go back to that home screen experience, you can quickly see what's in that cart, see what's in that wish list, and complete that purchase. So like if you click on your wish list, for example, we'll showcase that. This is a way for you to see those things hop back to the games you express interest in. And another change we made really excited about is recently viewed.
Oh, yeah. Look at this.
You've been looking at things in the store and say, hey, I remember looking at a game recently that was pretty exciting to me, but I can't easily get back there, but I want to put a notification on. I want to put it in my wish list. You can do that. And one of the great things about wish list is when a game goes on sale, we give you a notification. So that way, you know, if you put something in your wish list and say, man, I don't want to buy this now, but I'm excited to come back.
Yeah.
If that game ever goes on sale, we let you know to give you a good opportunity to get in there and buy that content at a deal.
There's also some other things here. I mean, here in this one, you can see friends that played the game. You see that at the top. We've seen that a little bit. We also see these, like right above here, we see the LB and RB. So there's a lot of tips to get you moving around here and where you want to go. In fact, up in the left-hand corner, you can see the view button. So that I know when I hit the view button, it instantly pulls out the menu, right?
Exactly. And so much of this for us is just trying to make things predictable and easy to read. You know, one of the things we know is we've got some diehard fans who are going to know this inside and out and be able to kind of do it with their eyes closed. But one of the things that's important to us when we think about an easier to use store is a store that is more inclusive for folks who might be new to our experience, might be new to the Xbox family, especially with the next generation of consoles. So giving us an opportunity to make sure that that is not just efficient and fast and really natural on your controller, but intuitive and really just kind of direct in terms of how I should use things, what I should do to close things.
I see some, I'm in this, I'm sorry, I'm in the settings here and I see these interesting about disable motions and autoplay sound. Tell us about that. That's great.
Yeah, this is huge. One of the common complaints we get a lot from fans, and it's actually interesting, it cuts both ways. We've tried to make some changes and have gotten feedback on both, is how video works and how sound works when you interact.
you and I have had many spirited conversations about this.
Many spirited conversations. Yeah, I've been pulled apart on both sides on this. And ultimately, I think what we decided and I think is a really a principle of the new store all up is choice. We'd rather let people choose what they want to do. So if you actually press, you know, start at any time here and pull up the menu, we actually give you the choice in line to say, hey, do I want to turn off autoplay video? Do I want to turn on sound of autoplay videos?
Right.
Do I want to show have that set of control at your fingertips instead of trying to find one single way to do some of these things that we know people have different ideas and opinions on.
Yeah, I mean, here you can see you're going to see the trail at the top. You can see I'm like, oh, you know what? I don't want to hear sound or I don't want autoplay. Yeah, you can do that right there.
Exactly. And I thought I was going to hate it. Like I thought there's no way I want sound in my autoplay videos. And as I'm using the new store experience and browsing around, I actually really enjoy it. And I encourage everybody who gets their hands on the new store experience to try out some of those different settings and find out what works for them. They might be surprised.
The other, of course, you can redeem and do all of those things over here as well, like you've always been able to do. One of the other areas that we're focusing on, Cody, is safer. Tell us about that, because I was going through some of the notes here, and I have safer scribbled in the column of my notes. Tell us about that.
Safety is important to us. I think one of the things that we care a lot about in the store, the world of store especially, is you know, how do we make a store that doesn't just work for our, you know, for people like me who, you know, I'm a grown adult with lots of disposable income and I'm excited to play the full range of Xbox games, but also folks with families who maybe have kids that they want to do a little bit more to keep an eye on and control what they're playing and what they're seeing inside of the store. We've made a couple of really important changes. One of those, and some of these are a little harder to show with your account, I think it's useful to talk through for folks who are interested. One of the things we did is the store doesn't support anonymous logins anymore. So we ask people to sign in. Mm-hmm. You might not have even realized this as an Xbox customer that you could sign in without, you could go to the store without being signed in on an account. But it is actually an easy loophole for folks who had content restrictions to get around some of those things that we're helping close so we can make sure that the experience is more consistent.
Yep.
The other thing that we're really leaning in on is doing more to show the ratings in more prominent ways of content. So if you actually want to pop back to the store, one of the things that we worked really hard on that we're proud of is if you go to one of those game galleries, like new games.
That's good. We'll go down here.
Let's check out some. Yeah, we can check out something new.
Most popular. Like that's where we were.
Sounds great.
And then which one do you want me to go into?
Yeah, you can stop right here. And we got to go turn. We have to turn on our trailers again. We turned those off. we get in the setting. That's important. There you go. If you pop back in, you'll see that if we pop over to like Borderlands, for example, before the trailer runs, we actually. Looks like we might be having a little bit of a hiccup here. But before that trailer runs, we show a there you go, City Skylines. That's what it is. We can just watch one of these. We show this standardized ratings information. So
in the U.S., if you're in the U.S., then it's ESRB, and overseas it's PEGI and so forth. So
exactly, or CRO or whatever your regional ratings board will be. So if that game has a trailer, we're going to make sure that we always show a consistent ratings experience before that.
There's one.
And which is a really useful thing, not just for our customers, but for our publishers as well, where localizing and regionalizing all those trailers just to have different ratings information can be pretty messy. So us doing this in a consistent, automated way is safer for our fans. And it's also way more reliable, especially and inclusive for folks who you know, aren't in the US, and but maybe they still want to speak in English and they want to see the local ratings board. We're much better at giving them the right thing.
I just want to drill into one of the the game details page. We see this down here, but down here at the bottom, we also have screenshots in where it's included, which we didn't kind of in one of the earlier reviews. I didn't have that. Ratings. Talk about ratings. You guys have done a lot of work around ratings, haven't you?
Yeah, exactly. And this is a space too. And I think one of the things that's great about launching this experience in Insiders First is, this isn't really an ending point for this. This is a new starting point. We have lots of things that we're excited about bringing to the fore. So, you know, we've redesigned the ratings experience to make them easier to view, easier to filter. I think one of the things that we're excited about in the store is almost everything's filterable. So if you're looking at ratings and reviews, we're going to show you different ratings and filters and sorts that are available. If you pop back up a level to those top games, we can help you filter through some of those details there. So if you hit X to filter here, you can filter this list of most popular games by particular genres, or even star ratings or ESRB ratings. And once you're done with those things, pop back out and you'll see that this list has been filtered. You can sometimes filter your way down to a very small list of games, depending on where you start. But I love being to be precise. You know, I'm a big fan of strategy games, and I like playing cooperatively with my friends. Those filter features go a long way to making that easy to do.
Yeah, and you can look at you like I say, to your point, if you can go into the any one of these filters and click on coming soon and go, you know what? Show me all the ones that are teen so I can figure out, or even everyone, what are the games I can play with my family? And there you go. And they can see
exactly. And making it easy to shop with your family is a huge part of what we're hoping to do here. So yes. I think there's a lot of advantages there. And we do really similar things on movies and TV. We show standard pre-roll ratings before movie trailers. I think that was a place where we've gotten feedback in the past where, man, it seems kind of inconsistent that a trailer for a movie that's rated R could show, but I can't see a teen game. And it was a good opportunity for us to look through some of those places where there were inconsistencies or issues and help get those things taken care of.
And you can kind of see we didn't spend a lot of time in the movies, but the movies area got this similar treatment of exactly the same things, the different versions, the different formats. So that's real helpful.
Exactly. Yeah. This, what we're really excited about is this update to our visual language is really all across the app. It's for our apps. It's for, hardware, movies and TV, in addition to games. Obviously we at Xbox love games, but, we have all kinds of great content in our store and, we want to make sure that we celebrate that stuff well.
I also want to point out, Cody, this is the store update, which is going to be rolling out obviously to insiders now and to everyone else later on the year. Yeah. Obviously since it's going to insiders now, people are going to get this on whether they have an Xbox One or an Xbox if they buy an Xbox Series X, you're going to see the same thing, correct?
Yeah, totally correct. And I think that's another thing that was important to us is, we love our Xbox One fans. Today they're our most loyal customers. And we want to make sure that when we're thinking about how we make the store better, we make it better for everybody. So this experience that you're going to get, you're going to see on your Xbox One today. And it's only going to get better on Xbox Series X, where the hardware is even more powerful. All the great performance wins that we're doing now for the store only get better on the next generation of Xbox consoles.
I know it's very exciting. Don't want to spend too much time in the store because, we've done a lot of stuff here. People need to go read the blog post over at Xbox Wire. I'll have a link. And then if you're not in Insiders, you need to sign up for Insiders. But if you're not, don't worry about it because this store will become the store. What are the plans for the rollout, Cody?
Yeah, that's a great question. So we're going to start the rollout, basically this week. We're going to start gradually rolling it out to customers, and we're going to take it through the insiders for a week or two, get feedback, make sure that things are comfortable. And then from there, we're going to start turning it on for some kind of at random customers inside of our general audience to see how it performs, make sure that it's stacking up well, people are happy, our customers are happy. Our hope is that as early as September, we're going to have this turned on for all fans. But it's important to us that for something as important as store, which our customers use every day, we get it right. And we're going to take the time and to make sure that we're building the best experience we can and that it feels like an improvement to everybody who uses it.
And I also want to point out that, you guys have migrated to this brand new platform, which is going to provide you a lot more flexibility. So you're going to be able to innovate even quicker, I assume, right?
That is correct. Yeah. React Native on Windows has been a huge watershed shift for us in terms of being able to not just make things performant, but be so much more agile. The time it took for us to build this store, while it was a lot of work, was a fraction of the work that it required to build the previous store that we had launched. And we've found that we can go from new idea to execution and testing sometimes in less than a week. And it's really exciting as a foundation for us to build off of. We're so excited for what we're going to be able to do this holiday and beyond.
I'm really excited, guys, getting a brand new store experience coming to Xbox Insiders and everybody else in the coming months. Cody Bird from the Xbox store or Microsoft store, appreciate you joining the team. And thanks again for all the work you do. And I'm looking forward to checking out all that feedback, right?
Yes. Thanks, Larry. Yeah, I appreciate the opportunity to share it. And I'm so excited to hear what our fans have to say.
Thank you so much, Cody. If you like what you see here, and I got to think, how do you not love that speed? Keep an eye out if you're an Xbox insider. Take a look at the content that's coming as those come through into that app. And you're going to want to be one of the first to get a hold of it. Of course, it will be coming to everybody, but your feedback super well appreciated. So thanks, Cody, for taking the time to really walk us through that.
That was a lot of fun.
Through it.
And we found a little bug there that they're already fixing. That's the beauty of insiders. You help us make things better, get an early look, and you may find a bug or two. Just make sure you send the feedback, file feedback.
So. All right, that's one of the reasons I wanted to come work here, to be able to see things as they're getting built, help to contribute. So I love that.
You are in the sausage factory, aren't you?
You and me both.
So yeah, that's the way it is. Anyway, we've got a few more things to talk about, and then we're going to wrap up here. What do you got over there, Jeff? You got a couple items, right?
Yeah. So this is something that a lot of Xbox Game Pass fans have been waiting for some time. And just last week, Yakuza Kiwami 2 showed up in the store last Thursday. This is a franchise that I'd heard about. I thought I knew what it was about, but I never really tried it. And it, you know, Yakuza 0 came into Game Pass, then Kiwami, and I've gotten so into this. So I'm wrapping up, I'm tying up a few loose ends of a few other story games that I'm playing. And as soon as I finish that up, it should be honestly in the next day, I'm jumping headlong into Yakuza Kiwami 2. I cannot wait. I've heard really good things about this one. And I just love that Game Pass was able to turn me on to this this other genre, this other franchise.
Worked. That Game Pass thing worked. You discovered your next great game.
And these are great games. I'm telling you, if you think you know what it's about, and you think it's just a bunch of brawling, yes, there's a ton of that, but like the story is so good. I'm just super into it, and I cannot wait for Yakuza Like a Dragon, which will be coming out later this year. That's going to be a really fun one. A completely different take on the Yakuza world.
For the very first time. Oh, never mind. Not that song.
Thank you, Madonna.
Yes, very good.
So here's a game that you've been trying out that sell me on it in 30 seconds or less. The return of Destroy All Humans, which is now out on Xbox.
You can see that. It's back here on my. Yeah, you can't see it right now. I just out of shot. I love the first one so much, and I just in fact, yeah, you can see it right here. I love the first one so much, and it's just silly 50s alien 50s Americana fun. And it's I'm unlocking achievements, which is always a bonus. But I'm just having a great time with it. If you want to see what it's like to destroy all humans from the alien side, as opposed to the human side, go ahead and check this out.
Sounds a little bit like Carrion, which a lot of people are playing right now and is currently in Game Pass, where you're playing the monster in a horror game and you're taking out all the people that are trying to end you.
Yeah, this is just they've taken the campiness level and just dialed it up. So it's just stupid fun. So blow things up. There's the mind meld and the anal probe and all the stuff you expect from alien lore. So yeah, you'll see.
Okay.
You'll see.
Okay.
You'll see. What else we got?
From campy to realistic, we had a great piece on Flight Simulator, on Microsoft Flight Simulator, which is coming out later this month. So excited for this. I bought a new computer. I haven't had a gaming PC, like a proper gaming PC, in a very long time.
Got a nice piece on Xbox Wire about it, by the way.
Yeah, who wrote up He used to play a lot of the flight sims, and he lived in Hawaii, and he went back home, and it's something we can't do right now. And it just looks beautiful. I saw a great article on Digital Foundry talking about, and here's the thing that I thought was really cool about that, which is like, look, the proper way to play this game is like as a sim with, it's not even a game. To play the simulator is really like if you've got a yoke and you've got the throttle and you've got the pedals and all that stuff. But the game's coming to Xbox Game Pass.
Yeah.
And if you turn on all the assists, you can actually play this with a controller or a mouse and keyboard, and you'll be able to get off the ground. It might not be like amazing. You're not going to be flipping all the switches, but it has those assists on. And if you just want to get into the air
and enjoy the beauty,
see the world, you can do that. And it's never been more approachable because it's on Xbox Game Pass for PC, or it will be. You'll be able to pre-download that pretty soon. So I just cannot wait.
And more importantly, in this flight, you will not have a middle seat. You're in the driver's seat.
Yeah, you're right. You're right in the front.
You're right in the pilot seat. You're making it happen. So it's a lot of fun and lots of beautiful scenery for you to see.
Don't sell it short. This is one of the most stunning games that I've ever seen in motion. Yeah. I mean, it's the world. It's you got to see it. You got to see it. And I think you can see a lot of
this story.
Creators are starting to post on it.
I think I told the story a couple times here. I mean, I remember playing it on an IBM PC when it was just a green screen and the horizon and I remember there was always this really like it felt like an 8-bit version of, I don't even know what it's called now, the Sears Tower, the Hancock Tower in Chicago, and going into Midway Field. It was amazing. And to see the realism now, the weather, the traffic, just the whole thing is just mind blowing.
You can find your house. You can find your house.
I did. I found my childhood house. I found the first apartment I lived. I mean, the whole thing. You can go right down memory lane. Wow. Have fun.
Yeah.
I'm going to go find the fountain blue.
30,000 feet. It's not going to be hard to find, Larry. It's right where the street sort of A1A goes up and then a little bit to the west.
Can I land? Maybe I'll drop it and land in A1A.
It'd actually be pretty cool. Make sure it's a Cessna, small plane. I don't know if A1A can handle a 737 or
anything
something.
Anything bigger than that.
Last thing, you had Wire Up, if you want to bring it back up. Outer Worlds, Peril on Gorgon. This was an expansion to the Outer Worlds, which came out last year, and this expansion was first announced just a week and a half ago during our Xbox Game Showcase. I cannot wait to jump back into that world. But here's more details on Xbox Wire. It's written up by Mikey Dowling down there at Obsidian. And he basically talks about like the raising of the level cap, the type of stuff you're going to be doing. And I am all about it. I am in. There it is. I am in for more Outer Worlds. And this tells you more than
Mike,
we knew.
Mike, you did write this. I totally forgot that. Yeah.
Yeah, of course. And in true spacer fashion, the board is there's a lot of different asterisks and the corporation's not necessarily a friend here.
I'm looking forward to going back down there to September. See that team down in Orange County when we're free to travel again.
I've never been there. I knew you were there for the launch of Outer Worlds, right? Didn't you do a stream there?
Yeah,
I've never been there.
I would love to go down there. Maybe, you know what, Jeff? You know, maybe we should take a road trip. I know that our respective wives would love to get us out of the house.
So. Yeah, I don't know. They might change the locks when I get back, but I would love to go down there and meet those folks when it is safe to do so.
Absolutely, absolutely. So there we go. Fun stuff. What else do we have? It's kind of wrapped this week.
That's the news.
Yeah, I mean, we're posting this, as I said earlier, we're posting this a little bit weird time Monday so that we could, you know, show off the brand new store, which we just announced earlier today, coming to Xbox Insider, coming to everybody later this year. So that's a lot of fun. So file your feedback on that because we want to make sure everybody gets a chance to check it out. So
absolutely. You're going to want it.
You're going to want it. Yes. There's, in fact, just kind of don't have a choice. You're going to eventually get it. So that too.
No choice. You're going to be happy to have it. Trust me on that.
It is. This is an awesome thing to have. So, all right. Well, why don't we wrap it up here, Jeff? Maybe we'll do another show later this week or next week. We'll take a look at the schedule. We got a lot of stuff coming. A lot of news coming out. We got a lot of cool stuff. So if you'll come back on, love to have you. If you, dear listener, would like to and viewer would like to come back on, let us know. Jeff, how should people, you know, engage with us? Could you tell us that, please?
Well, I mean, you could follow Larry on Twitter at Major Nelson. That's also his gamer tag. Or for me, if you, the complaint desk, as I calls it, at Jeff Rubenstein, or my gamer tag. I just want to thank the folks at Maxnomic. Part of the Xbox Gear team got us some very nice embroidered chairs. It's so comfortable. I'm very much. I feel like I should be streaming more.
This is the next version. Did they make the bottoms wider? It feels like it's wider.
A little more room. It's definitely firmer. It's better on the back because I normally don't sit throughout the day because it just doesn't feel good to me. But this chair, I've sat for hours and hours, and I'm like, this is good. This is what I'm playing Apex in every night.
Hit at Jeff Rubenstein up, or if you're watching this on YouTube, you know the drill.
Like, subscribe, and set that notifications bell. You'll love it, Larry. You'll love it.
Love having you guys here. All right, gang. We'll talk to you on the next show. Jeff needs to hydrate here, and we need to get back to grounded. We need to hydrate not only here, but in grounded. So there we go.
All right, true. I'm looking up for dew right now to refill my cup.
All right. Be careful out there. All right, gang. We'll see you guys next time. Catch us up online, and have a great time. And check out all those great games in Game Pass. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.